Next up, we have another speaker who's going to be sharing his incredibly inspiring story. Please help me give a warm welcome to Drew Brophy.
Howdy, folks. It's nice to see you from here, looking out over all these faces that I've met over the past couple days. And I'm hoping that this story inspires you and teaches us all a lesson that we're much more powerful than any of us ever realized. I'm coming up on a year, last year, where they told me I was going to die. Doctor asked me to say goodbye to my wife, Maria, there, through a window, as they put me in a coma, and I watched the world slip away. But I was not afraid. I told her I got this. The doctor only said I was going to be out for a few days at most, that I possibly might wake back up. Days turned to weeks. Weeks turned into a month. I'm not sure exactly when it happened, but I floated right out of my body. I instantly knew that I was not this body. It was clearly obvious. It was seamless. Your consciousness does not stop. In that same instant, I felt part of everything and everyone, like I'd lived every one of your lives and everybody else's at the same moment. It was beautiful. I instantly had compassion for all the people. The thought was, oh my gosh, they don't get it. You don't think about anything in these moments. You don't think about stuff. You don't think about what you would have done. All you think about is people. It's like it's all there, this massive download. It happens in an instant. I had all these little bites come up around me. I was light. It was glorious. It was like billions of little children tickling me. It was like a river of light, a flow. It's not something you see, it's something that you feel. It's something that you're remembering who you really are. Shortly thereafter, another big light came up and caught me. I instantly felt, oh, thank God, he's got me. It felt like my father. It felt so good. I later realized it was even more than that. It was like all the ancestors that came before me. I was with them. I never left them. I was a part of them. Soon thereafter, another light came. It hit us like a truck. It was big, powerful. I had no idea or any inclination of who or what it was. All I know is it hit us hard. It pushed us even faster through the flow. It was vigorously swooshing these little lights away from me that were swarming around me like moths to a flame. It was just whoosh, whoosh, little things would go flying. We were going so fast in this river, that I thought I couldn't hang on anymore. It was all just happening. All this happened in like there was no time. All of a sudden, when I just thought I couldn't hang on anymore, it just all stopped. Everything was still. I could see the river of light, and it was going off in the distance like a corkscrew or a spiral or something. And we were out of it. The thought was instant that I need to go back. And I was sad because I'd forgotten about this place. I'd forgotten about Maria and Dylan. I instantly remembered it. It's like, oh yeah, they're waiting for me, I promised. I didn't know how to get back. They just gently pushed me down. And I floated down. I didn't feel anything until the last minute. It was like this big squeeze, like I was in a trash compactor. I woke up. It'd been a month. It was Christmas Day. What I didn't know is I was paralyzed. I couldn't talk. I couldn't move. Everybody around me had face masks and face shields. I couldn't understand what they were saying. And that's when the battle began. It was terrifying, painful, cruel. I couldn't breathe. You're on a ventilator and they tell you to breathe and you can't. Your heart freaks out and you feel like you're drowning. But what saved me is this experience. I thought to myself, they can't kill me. I'm the light. I saw it. I saw who I really was. Who all you are. You're powerful. I held that in my mind and stared at those blank walls. So my wife came in. She had been fighting for me the whole time. She had put it out on the internet that I was fighting and that I was coming home. People around the world were praying for me. That's what those little lights were. They were giving me energy. I could see them. Your intentions are powerful. They mean something. My wife fought for things to keep me alive. We're like, just meant to be together. We were going through a lesson. She on the outside, on the inside. It was brutal, but we fought. I spent the last 7 months learning how to walk, talk, eat, everything again. It's a miracle I'm standing here. I can't even believe it. It doesn't seem real. It seems like a distant dream, all that stuff that happened. Richard told me to come here. It was what we looked forward to. It gave me strength to get better so I could come here. I wanted to try the medicine to see if it was the same place. It was. You see who you really are. You are everything. You are the universe. You are the power. We forgot. It's time to remember. You're all powerful. This is the first time I've told this story publicly. I couldn't think of a better group of people to tell it to. Thank you.